I've had to stop down. Had my hands full this morning getting going. Got here early too. Give y'all a little rundown of what we're doing. Earlier, I set up over here, right in here, so I can reach across, all that. Set up for trucks to come around me, go by me. I set up facing me, facing the camera right here. Figured trucks would get by me and back up and then get in and out. Got over there and, long story short, the first driver drove right off in the only hole in 3-acre lot. They were concerned that they're gonna get stuck, and I mean, it's dry, it's a little bit soft on top, there's fill dirt or whatever, but I think they would have been fine. Anyway, we moved over here and set up, which I originally looked at this spot, and I would have liked to have gotten farther up in here. It just made everything easier to reach and all that, but he's concerned about the trucks backing down this hill and getting in and out, which I don't think would have been a problem. And anyway, we got over here and got set up. We got all the tires off the ground. Get these balls out of here. Road right there or whatever, and they're coming in washing out right over there. He's got a box for them. But I should be able to reach everything from here just fine. For a minute, I'll stop and save some battery, and we'll get back to you in a little bit. All right, we're back in business. Oh, I think that tree's gonna be in the way. We got 220 ordered, we got 68 on the ground. We'll be right back. Well, waiting again. This is what we like to call a, and this is where the duck quacking is going to come into play, but this foul language, it's a one truck blank, meaning we get one truck at a time, which I understand they're busy and all that or whatever, but come on guys, give me some concrete, let's go. We actually had two trucks pull up at the same time. That's one I finished just a minute ago. This one's backing in. There's another one out there. Three trucks in a row, pretty quick. I'm gonna put a battery in it so we'll stop down for a minute. We'll give y'all a little ride along here.
He's honking, means he's ready.
Salesman says 20 minutes to the next truck, and 2 minutes later there's another one pulling up. And there's another one. That was a quick 20 minutes.
I guess their track is not working.
That didn't sound good. That's probably a big rock stuck in that reducer up there. Alright, what's happening here is occasionally we'll get a big rock, gets through the gate on the hopper, and it gets stuck in this as a reducer. It goes from 5 to 4 inches. Anyway, back to pump up, get the pressure off of it, open it up, take the reducer off and clean it out. That's got it cleaned out. The thing about rock packs like that are they're like snakes. When you see one, there's usually another one around. So we'll be careful with it here in a minute, here for a minute, and see how it does. Turn forward, nice and slow. That is what you call a fin fish. That's just buildup on inside of the drum of the cement truck. And it bounces around and gets knocked off, and we find it here the hard way. Let's try some more. Stretched out that way. Outrigger in the dirt pile on that side. That's what you get here. Back foot's off the ground. But it's all good. See what kind of mess we made back here. Rock. Another rock. All right, we got like this one, and they're gonna have to call for a tag, I think. This one might finish that back there in the corner and the back patio, and then they got this right here. We got our last truck here. He's getting wet. Get over here. We got a little bit left in this porch, and then that drive-through, whatever it's called. This was the first part that we poured. The garage. Not really kind of sort of detached. There'll be a roof over this part, but. Kind of a separate piece than the rest of the house. There's a garage here and another garage over there. This will be covered. Roof over it here with the driveway coming out behind me.